with summer. We all want to look a little better and feel better, but how do we do that for summer and beyond? Luckily, I'm joined by an expert in exactly that topic, a registered dietitian and co-founder of Nourished Roots, Leah Baker. Leah, thank you for joining me on the show today.
Yes, of course. It's my pleasure. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, I really want to talk specifically, if we could, about how to eat to lose weight and feel better in that perimenopause and menopause stage. Why in that particular age range is it so hard to seem to lose weight?
Yeah, it can be very difficult. So women who are entering into menopause, our reproductive hormone estrogen decreases, and this naturally has an impact on our metabolism, specifically on how we metabolize fat and store fat in the body, making it a lot more difficult for women to see changes in their body weight, particularly if you are seeing that you're gaining weight entering into those menopausal years and you're wanting to lose weight. You might just wake up one day and say, my body's completely different. I don't know myself anymore. What's changed? And this is the process that takes place.
Yeah, so how can we start to maintain a healthy weight, much less lose weight, when we enter into those years? Because I think women, you know, there's a wide age range, obviously, that covers. So what is the key so that we can actually make strides and not get frustrated and just throw our hands up altogether?
Yes, that's a great question. So I have some small tips here on how women can get started at home and see a difference right away in their energy and in their metabolism. So one great way for you to notice a difference in your routine and really at any stage of life, this is a great tip, is to eat your larger meals earlier on in the day, because this will help you to remain satisfied longer throughout the day, also entering into that evening time. So that's really where satiety can be a big advantage. Having eaten some good hearty meals earlier on, you're, you know, entering into the evening where a lot of snacks come into play. A lot of appetizers are pulled out of the fridge at dinner time, and you're seeing higher calorie foods.
That is such a good tip. And, you know, I think we keep hearing about all these diets that make us get rid of everything, right? But you have a really good tip that I'm excited to try about not just getting rid of everything, but what can help women in this stage?
Yes. Eating a mildly reduced carbohydrate diet can be very useful. So, and I'm not saying that carbs are the enemy here. They're very nutritious and nutrient packed, but just having a mildly reduced carbohydrate diet. Mm-hmm. So eating about 30 grams carbs at meals, 15 grams at snack time. That's been proven to help women who are menopausal maintain their weight a little bit better. And then also following a more plant-based diet. Mm-hmm. So if you've not heard of this type of eating, it's just, changing, going from a more meat-centric diet and incorporating more fresh plant foods into your routine, which naturally are less processed and lower in added sugar, calories, and added fat as well. So just overall healthier.
That's so helpful. I mean, just even that awareness, even you giving us some numbers or some tips of not eradicating everything, I think knowledge helps give us more power. Leah, tell us more about nourishroots.com, where people can find you and what they'll find when we're there as we wrap up.
Yeah, so if you go to our website, you'll see that we have events on one of our tabs. We host a lot of free webinars open to the public. You can register for those. We post a lot of recipes. You'll see our one-on-one nutrition counseling services. So we do take clients. And also a great way for you to follow us is on our Instagram.
Thank you so much. I can't wait to embrace this. I hope you'll try it as well. Leah, thank you for joining us today.
Thanks so much.